Each news time, information is power. The current, the news headline. Buba Galadima dismisses Igbo presidency, says declaring bandits terrorists is a waste of time. The news in full. Buba Galadima also dismissed the agitation for Igbo presidency and said it is not different from the agitation for Biafra. Alhaji Buba Galadima has dismissed calls for Igbo presidency in 2023, and according to the former ally of President Muhammadu Buhari, calling for Igbo presidency is not different from the agitation for Biafra. Galadima also dismissed the branding of bandits as terrorists by the federal government, saying it shows they know who the bandits are all along. He made his view known in an interview with Vanguard's Chioma Gabriel. The federal government recently branded bandits as terrorists, and Sheikh Gumi said it is a waste of time on the part of the government. In all honesty, the implications for this declaration might actually bring about more mayhem, and therefore people who are actually perpetrating this evil act, where the highest authorities could have done is to what the highest authority could have done is to propagate an act or law saying that anyone caught doing banditry would face public execution or firing squad or whatever. But you can't declare somebody without an address, without a name, or anything, just like that. You can only deal with the action. The action of banditry can be tackled if you catch somebody in the act. You can deal with the person, but not allow outlaw the person, because these people are actually faceless. Saying that if you outlaw bandits, you are telling us that all along you know who they are, and you have been lying, and you are in synergy with them. But they have somebody who is linked to them, like the famous Sheikh Gumi, and comparing them, because IPOB is a known organization. They have leaders who are known, and they have account numbers, and people are even paying into their account number abroad and inside Nigeria to facilitate their activity. Name who claimed they were members of the Eastern Security Network and now of the Indigenous People of Biafra. The video of the killing has gone viral, sending chill down the spines of many. In a statement, however, the governors led by Dave Umahi of Ebonyi State said they will investigate the development. The statement read, "We warn all criminals who have styled themselves as IPOB BSN to kill our people to immediately stop. We are aware that the insecurity and killings in the southeast have gone beyond IPOB BSN, as any criminal finds to it easy to hide under such a name to commit crimes. We are determined to do everything to protect the lives and properties of our people. Our youth are advised to leverage on the various empowerment and agricultural programs by our governors to better their lives. We condemn in strong terms the video clip and write-up we saw in some social and print media where two policemen were said to have been killed and their heads cut off by youth who style themselves as members of IPOB ESN, they said. We are resolved among ourselves to work with security agencies to determine work with authenticity of this video report, and if found to be true, to apprehend the perpetrators by all possible means to face the law. We are aware of similar videos in the past, which, when subjected to forensic review, were found out to have happened outside Nigeria. We therefore assure Nigerians, especially the police community, that we will not rest until we have done justice to this matter." And these are the Southeast governors speaking on the video of that surfaced recent on the social media, where two policemen were allegedly said to be killed in that video, whereby Dave Umahi of Ebonyi State said that they would investigate the development and also warn all criminals styling themselves as IPOB or ESN to kill people to immediately stop such thing that would provoke tension and mayhem in the community, where they actually said that they are assuring Nigerians, especially the police community, the governor saying that they would not rest until justice is actually done to this matter at hand. And therefore, they have said that they are aware, that there is truly insecurity and killings in the southeast, but there are still some findings there about that criminals
are the one finding it so easy, so as to, you know, use the IPOBSN to perpetrate this evil act.
Jonathan was said to have urged leaders to focus more on building a United Nations where no one nation or nations should be given more prominence. If the leaders deviate, there must be a dissension and frustration for those who feel they are not being treated fairly, he said. Jonathan, a former president and a member of graduate class in 1981 at the University of Port Harcourt, said the reunion program was part of a group of student activities aimed at strengthening relationships between older alumni. He also said it is a forum to discuss issues affecting their alma mater and bring them back to school and the community at large. For his part, King Tuna said it was good to reunite his classmates after 40 years apart.
Saraki made this intention known before his visit to the governor of Benue State, Samuel Otto, on Tuesday in Makurdi, whom he called a good party man under the People's Democratic Party. According to the report, Saraki was in Makurdi with former governor of Kogi State, Idris Wada, former national chairman of the PDP, Kawu Baraji, Senator Suleiman Adokwe, and chairman of Council Saraki for President Campaign, Professor Iyowese Haya. A political party that cannot organize its affairs has no business leading this country. A party that has organized its leaders, its affairs, is ready to lead the country, and that is PDP, Saraki is said to have stated. Autumn, on the other hand, stated that the PDP was on a rescue mission to save Nigeria from the current all-progressive Congress government. He also noted that Saraki was the first from the North Central Zone to declare his interest in running for president for 2023. The former governor of Kwara State also stated via his Twitter handle that he was ready to work with the party stakeholders in the North Central region while commending them for warm reception. He wrote, "I thank Governor Autumn and all our party stakeholders and supporters in the state for the warm reception, and I look forward to working with them to foster the growth and development of our party and our nation." Another breaking news is that the lawyer who sued celebrities for supporting NSAS reportedly killed in Anambra State, where the human rights law activist and lawyer Kenechukwu Okeke has reportedly been murdered in Anambra State. His family made the disclosure on Thursday, stating that Okeke was allegedly macheted by his attackers, numbering 7 in his compound, and a keg of fuel poured on him because he was lit up and left to burn to death, according to a report by Daily Post. The controversial activist had filed criminal complaints before a magistrate court in Abuja against 50 persons over their alleged involvement in NSAS protests last year. Some of the persons listed in the suit include Nigerian football star Kanu Nwankwo, musicians Folarin Falana, better known as Faust, Innocent Idibia, aka Tubaba, and David Adeleke, better known as Davido.